ladies and gentlemen. Now, where we last left off, last session, is you are now back at the original room where you all started at. A bomb has exploded, the entire party is on their asses and just getting up. You were exploring the catacombs, you encountered some monsters along the way, and you also encountered a special hilt of a sword that helped you along your path that you almost died to with our dear friend Oberon. Now that you're all assembled here within this room, flat on your asses, and still exploring the catacombs, which you were, you have an option. You can go exploring again, or you can go back upstairs. What will you do?
Let's explore some more.
Did we explore literally everything?
We covered a lot of ground, but I think we still have some areas that are fresh.
Indeed.
Then I would gladly help it.
Okay. Currently, are you... What will you do?
What choices do we have for direction?
Right now, in terms of direction, you can go to your left side or through the explosion that just occurred in the rubble.
I like explosions.
Ooh, let's go to where the rubble is.
Yeah, let's figure out what was hiding behind that trap.
So... Who's gonna go investigate it?
Me!
Okay, so you, as you're investigating, I want you to roll an investigation check for me.
Yes, sir.
What you get?
Hold on. My thing's being stupid. Give me a second. It's taking its sweet time. Come on, stupid.
You knew where to click, right?
Yes. I got a 14.
Okay, duly noted. So, now, Ava, as you're exploring this explosion, what you come to find is in the back corner of this room, there is a skeleton of a man holding a book, and there is a number of wine bottles scattered about the floor.
Can I do an perception check on the book?
You can just pick up the book.
Okay.
You pick up the book, and upon looking at it, you find the title says... The title is... Now it is, upon picking up the book, it is a play. And this play was The Lusty and Argonian Maid.
Huh. I'm gonna open the book and look through it.
That's from Skyrim, I'm dying.
As you look Classic. Through the book, you find yourself enriched in the swelling acts of a romance plot, very similar to a pornographic novel, in which a lizard is trying so desperately to attempt to fuck a dragon, and the dragon is playing hard to get. As you read deeper and deeper, I want you to make a, make a wisdom save.
Oh, Lord. Okay.
What'd you get?
I got a 2.
Oh, okay. So,
oh Lord,
you feel enriched by the book as you continue to read further and further. You start feeling yourself heating up a bit, getting a little flustered by what you're reading, but you can't stop reading. As you then get past the first two acts, going into the third, where then you see, inside your mind's eye, you can see the dragon. You can see how large and bountiful his boon is, how large his member is. You are quite enjoying yourself. The rest of the party is seeing you quiver as you read this book, getting quite flustered. I want you to make another wisdom save for me.
Oh god.
Please don't die.
Should I fix this?
Do I see... Is it like a spell happening, or they're just reading?
They're just reading.
I got a four.
As you read further and further, you notice that you're getting very hot and heavy as you start to get to the good part of the play. For two whole acts, the dragon is railing this Argonian, and you realize that by the end of the book that you have read and scanned through all this time, that you now have gained a custom feat.
Of what?
Your custom feat is Dragon Breeder. You can now fuck dragons with twice the proficiency.
Dear God.
Lizard folk. You also have increased persuasion attempts upon all lizard and dragon folk, including lizard and dragon-like monsters.
Omega.
Well, that poor tiny body. Oh my God. Okay.
So, what will you all do now?
No comment.
The rest of the party, all you can see is she's like kind of quivering and moving about, fidgeting, really, like just really fidgety and very flustered as she sets down the book and looks at you all. A little dazed.
Oh no.
Perception check.
She would totally be covering your face.
23.
Oh. So, Corona, as you've buried yourself many times in books, but you have come across a number of romance novels and heard a number of things in bars and stuff, you would know this is what the term of what most common folk refer to as cum drunk.
She's fine. She's a bit more than fine, but she's fine. Okay, moving on. Where else can we go?
Can I check out the wine bottles that are on the ground? Are there anything in them?
You can check.
I shall check. Roll perception?
Yep.
Or investigation?
I want you to roll investigation for me to see how many you can find, and then roll perception.
Okay, I got a 17 on my investigation.
You managed to secure almost every wine bottle on the floor, and you can now look inside them. Perception with advantage.
I got a 12.
Did you roll with advantage, though?
No.
Because you technically have all the bottles, you can just look into them.
Oh, how do you roll with advantage?
You can roll it twice.
Right click.
Oh.
Right click and it gives you advantage and disadvantage.
Oh. Okay, so reroll and with advantage, so I got 20.
You've secured about 4 open bottles of this mysterious wine. Upon sniffing it, though, you notice that this wine has almost honey-like aroma, along with a fair hint of just what you think is to be almost like a beef. It's like beefy and honey.
I want to take a sip.
Okay.
Oh, no.
You take a sip of this wine. Upon doing so, you feel a very warm sensation get covered across your body as it's very, very sweet, along with a very almost grainy-like texture to it. It's very thick, very gelatin-like. And
oh no.
It just tastes very gelatin-like and very thick and viscous.
Anything else? I'm good. That's it.
You can roll. I'll say that, are you going to take another look at the bottle?
Yeah, I'll look again, I guess. Should I roll perception? Again?
Mm-hmm. With advantage.
Okay. That's 20.
Okay. You notice that this doesn't really taste like alcohol.
Oh, no.
It has a very sweet scent to it, but it's very, very, very thick and viscous, and it doesn't really taste like alcohol to you.
Does it taste like bananas?
You can't quite put your finger on it, but it does have a sort of seasonal taste of meat. Very, have you ever, like, you know what I'm talking about? Like, with, like meaty gravy? Like, little chunks of meat in it?
Yeah.
Almost like it's clumped up and it's been here a while.
There's nothing else I can do. I'm fucking putting it down. I don't want it. Gross.
Upon putting it down, did you want to look where the wine bottles came from? Because they were in the corner there. You notice there's some other wine bottles next to this desk, but they're under it.
I'll look into it, yeah.
You look over, and you find these wine bottles, and then you see that a couple of them have some almost weird, like the sludge has been spilled over on it, as if something was being shot into it.
Oh no!
I'm concerned.
This whole room has a certain theme to it. You put it in your mouth.
No.
I did. I mean, is there anything else I could do to figure out what the fuck it is?
Make a nature check.
I knew. I fucking knew. I was waiting. I was like, when am I gonna make a fucking nature check? God damn it. I got an 8. Oh, I got 10, actually.
Okay, so you're not very sure about interspecies, but you can realize that this is semen.
Okay. I'm not going to tell anyone else. I'm just going to clear my throat and put all the bottles down and just kind of walk away from it.
Mr. Lion, where are you going?
I think we've investigated enough in this room. I think we can move on.
Yes, I think. Oh no.
I just want to say, canonically, I feel like I would just came down here after yelling at the kids who didn't make my margarita as I asked them to. So that's why I wasn't here for the earlier portion. But immediately after coming in here and seeing someone reading a book desperately, I would instinctually go over to try and see more about it.
Ava, are you going to let him?
No, because she's going to be holding the book like to her chest and dancing in almost like an antsy way. Like, I'm not horny, no, I'm not thinking about it.
Go to horny jail.
Bonk.
So, I swear I'm not thinking about it.
So, what you gonna do there, friendo? What you gonna do? You gonna try to pry it from her?
Slut?
Sorry, I got completely confused. What?
Or? Are you gonna... What are you gonna do?
I was gonna go ask her if I can read the book. Can I perchance look at that book? I have quite the collection of books.
No, it's mine. She'd basically turn around and, like, just run in the corner.
Oh. You're... I mean, that was not to say it shouldn't help. No.
No.
Suspicious. I vote we send her out the airlock.
Oh. So... the only path left is to go left or return back upstairs.
And this is the small room, correct?
This is your starting room.
Oh, this is the starting room.
Left then?
Let's go left.
Hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Upon Ava would follow, but the book has now disappeared.
Oh no. You follow each other left, and you walk around, going through the catacombs, and you come to another room. The door is in front of you, as you can choose to enter. However, from this room, you hear some squeaking.
You said squeaking?
Yes.
Can I roll to check what it is?
Yeah.
Should it just be a perception?
Yeah.
Or investigation?
Perception.
Nat 20, plus 3.
Damn, so with your newfound echolocation, you can hear throughout the whole room the squeaking is coming from a number of rats squeaking to each other in sort of some kind of language that you don't really understand. And then they're squeaking and then they run off and you hear squeaking down the hall if they went down some kind of corridor.
I think they're talking.
I might be able to. Let me see if I have any spells for communicating with animals. Give me a sec while I look.
Did they notice us or no?
No, you're behind a door. They left and they're down a corridor.
Can we sneak to follow?
Well, you gotta enter the room first.
Can I sneak entering the room?
Yes, you can. Roll stealth.
Gladly. Hold on, let me get to my... Ooh, that's a 27.
Woo!
Okay. Oh.
So you just covertly sneak into the room, and as you sneak into this room, you see a very large humanoid figure in some kind of cape and robe with some kind of trident standing in a corner, hunched over, talking to these rats. And imbuing some kind of spell upon them as they rush in down the different corridors. These rats look a little grayish, similar to the metallic substance that is growing on Oberon.
Oh no.
I don't like this.
I don't like this at all. But
in this case, I will use my, I will write in my book, because I know that these folks have written their names in my book already. And I will write a message to all three of them saying, there seems to be someone here who has the same, how do I say, rust as Oberon does.
Oh no, that's bad.
You hear it in my voice.
As you keep looking, he doesn't know that you're there.
Hopefully.
And then the humanoid stands up. And you hear a slight bit of crunching and sort of moving of something inside the robe as you see it kind of like maul and twist a bit, almost deforming a bit from its humanoid shape as it crunches and skitters. And you can hear
it's
rattling.
A fucking series of rats in a trench coat.
You can hear it rattling all over as if there was almost something hard like a carapace.
It's a bug in a trench coat.
Oh, God.
I despise insects.
Attempted assimilation.
So.
No.
As this continues. It's sort of moving about. Just kind of in place. Not really. Anything else that you can really see right now? What will you do?
Wait a minute.
I can cast Pass Without a Trace on us if you guys want me to, if you want to follow.
I would love that. By the way, we can still have this sending.
Pog, pog, pog. Okay, so... Yeah, I'll cast Pass Without a Trace so that we are undetected.
As you do so, Daffer, Slut, sorry, Slut. I... Dear Slut.
Oh no.
Yeah?
Oh no.
Oh yes.
You can see that there are some wings growing under this trench coat, kind of sprouting out slowly as you hear loud cracking and crunching noises.
I'm writing in my book as fast as I can. Everyone, this creature seems to have wings, and it is cracking. Perchance, it is a gargoyle. And I put my pen down, and I come out of stealth, and I go to approach it, and I want to try to talk to the creature. After all, I have advantage and proficiency in seducing.
That's true.
Gargoyles!
I'm gonna stay on the other side of the door. This is already too much for me.
One moment.
So I want to go and talk to this creature. We're like, hello there.
One moment, please.
You have no idea what to do with
it. No. It's just I have to calculate something real quick.
Oh, God, no.
No.
That's suspicious.
Okay, that's just so you know, if I have to do a save against magic, I have advantage. All magic.
So, sus. From this, are you going to, like, tap on a shoulder or something? Or?
No, I was going to call out to him for, like, 15 feet away.
Call out to him. Upon doing so, the humanoid turns around, as you can notice that there's this mask on it. It's just a plain white mask. No holes, nothing. And it is surrounded by a tan-like cloak, with a hand that is concealed, covering and holding a trident.
I'm sorry. Could you say that again? I just need to comprehend it.
A long, tall figure,
mm-hmm.
humanoid in shape right now.
But with wings.
With a tan. Well, the wings are kind of forming. In the tan cloak with wings, which you can assume are wings, under its cloak. And it has a concealed armor as it's holding this trident. And it stands just looking at you.
How are you doing in this fine, I guess, evening at this point?
Well, I'm doing quite well.
Would I recognize that as the same kind of voice that Gargoyles had?
No. You notice this as to have a hint of, let me see actually if you can understand it first. What languages do you speak?
Sylvan and Common?
It sounds like gibberish to you. You then hear in the back of your head something of a deep, gurgly voice saying, "Hello."
Can... Can Slut hear us or no?
What do you mean?
Like, he telepathically spoke to us and vice versa. Be true or no?
You can speak back to me once per message. None of you have spoken back, so you can.
So, right now, I'm gonna ask, is it hostile?
It seems to, that's a good question.
This moment you're unsure.
I'm very unsure. What seems Would you like any assistance?
Assistance, you say? You still hear this message being played in the back of your head as it continues to talk to you with some sort of a spell. The message spell. As it's casting from its trident. And it says to you,
assistance, well, isn't that funny? For my master is always in need of more assistance with his job.
Well, what kind of master is he? I quite like having some men around.
Of them all.
Ooh, sounds powerful. Sounds devious. Can I speak to him?
If he grants it, you could. But as it is now, you're inferior.
In theory. Well, let's see. How about I help you out here, and then maybe we can be introduced? I would love an introduction.
He extends out his hand with the glove falling off. It's a little bit falling off, like kind of like drooping. Will you hold his hand and shake it? You're still 15 feet away. Will you walk up to him?
Well, my hands are gloved, but yes, I would. I would walk up to him and shake his hand with my nice silk glove.
How hard will you squeeze?
I will not squeeze. That slut is quite submissive.
Okay, so he holds your hand, and you hear a loud crunching as he moves his arms, and then you notice that there seems to be a lot of things moving underneath the glove, as if it's not just a hand under it.
Mm-hmm. Well then, how can I help you? Like, I don't know what else to say. I'm shaking his hand and I'm offering him help. I don't know.
While he's preoccupied.
I can bestow a gift upon you to meet my master.
Can I really quickly sneak inside the room while they're having this conversation?
You can try.
I think I would quite like that, yes.
Oh, this could be bad.
Corona got bored. In I go.
What did you roll?
Ooh. That was actually really scary and close. 25.
Can you sneak in just fine, stealthily in the corner? None of them, not even Slut, notices your presence.
Yeah, I don't have that high a passive.
So, upon shaking his hand and saying yes, you feel his hand clutch onto you and some purple light bewing across your hand.
For the gift I shall bestow upon you.
He tosses into the air iron dust. Breathe in.
Oh, shit.
You then see the iron dust bit sparkle and then zap onto your body, embedding itself into your skin.
Yep.
Oh, this is bad.
Yep, I should have seen this coming. Great news. Great news as this happened, because I do have something for this. Let's see. What is it? What is it called? I have stuff. In this case, I would cast an aberration. No, I would not. You know what? No, I won't attack.
Okay. Upon doing so, you can feel cold iron coursing now through your veins as you feel it seep up through your whole system. As you then see out from the pore from the very small wounds this iron dust made into you, a little bit of blood comes out, but then you can see that blood slowly turning and drying up into this silvery, metal-like substance.
Oh my god, you got infected like me. Oberon.
Oh my. This seems to be quite the scenario I've gotten myself into. Tell me, is this something that your master controls? This iron blood, or silver blood, whatever the...
Oberon and Sapphire, it's not Sapphire, Slut.
Slut.
I want you to both make an intelligence save.
Oh no.
Fuck me. Is it magical? Oh. Is it save against magic?
Not really.
Question. Mr.
Dan. Is it technically a magical effect?
Yes.
Okay, then I have advantage.
Do I see this going on or no?
That's great. I got a 10.
You
Fuck
do.
You, advantage.
I got 11.
I do. You see it going on with you see Slut get hit with this iron dust, but you don't really know what's going on as he's just kind of standing there, stone.
Okay. In that case, I'm gonna go ahead and really quickly ask Omen if he knows what the hell is going on and who that is.
So, as you gotta grab onto the hilt. So you grab onto the hilt through your backpack, and Omen then speaks to you in Celestial. For this sinner has purged himself with unholy magic.
It's is it the same unholy magic?
To your friend's unholy heresy.
Oh. My heresy is quite unholy, I will admit to that.
I would think it'd be very holy.
And so, both of you,
this character
and Slut, you hear a distant voice inside your head saying, hello, my children.
Oh, no.
It's been a bit of time, but I'll be sure to use you as wonderful pawn. And then fades away. For
the
master has spoken to you. You should be pleased. What were you going to do, Corona? It's told you that it's a very heretical magic.
Yes. Unfortunately, I don't want to kill Slut. That would be a bad.
That's fine.
What?
This character was literally based off of that TikTok. I fuck Cthulhu good.
Oh my god.
Yes, we know. I'm not trying to murder you, though.
I still have the element of surprise for the second. Can I use Phantasmal Force on this thing?
You can attempt to.
I think I will. Going to...
What is Phantasmal Force going to do?
Can craft an illusion that takes root in the mind of a creature that you can see within range. The target must make an int save. On a failed save, you create a phantasmal object, creature, or other visible phenomenon of your choice that is no larger than a 10-foot.
I need you to make another stealth check.
Can do.
Actually, question though, are you specifically aiming for him?
I'm aiming for his head, yes.
Okay. So, go ahead. Try to cast.
Okay. One cast of Phantasmal Force.
You could always use some sorcery points. I thought you were a sorcerer.
How much damage is it going to do?
It's a 1d6 as long as he's afflicted.
So,
but I choose what exactly he sees or hears.
When you try to hit this thing, you notice that you fling your spell, but then it zaps and hits his head. He then looks over as you then hear a voice in the back of your head, Corona. That was beautiful. He now can, and you hear a voice in the back of your head, Ava, and you, Oberon. I see you two behind the door.
Fuck.
No.
I mean, it is sentient, so... Confusion?
Fuck. It didn't affect him.
The nothing.
The phasmal force didn't do anything.
God damn it.
No, fuck.
Okay,
can we
you know
just
what?
Stay on this side of the door?
You don't seem
you
hostile.
You said it was a dex save, right?
It was an int save.
Okay, let me make the... I thought it was a dex save. Let me make an int save real quick. He still makes it.
Okay.
He made it by... It had to be a 19, right?
My int is actually... Wait a minute. There we go. No, it's an 18. You're right.
He got a 26.
Okay. Okay. Well, you don't seem hostile, if not a little bit weird. I'm just gonna step out. He clearly knows I'm here. What exactly are you?
What am I, you see? Thrive. For I am a servant of the Master, the one who calls himself the Metallic Magician.
And very clearly in need of a breath mint.
He hears that, and he holds out his hand.
Ah, I believe we have a mouth to feed in.
You then see his hand almost elongate and swarm grabbing onto your neck with a bunch of bugs connecting to his own body and yours as it wraps around you and starts covering you in bugs. Make a dex save.
Okie dokie.
Everyone roll for initiative.
Woo! Oh, fuck.
11.
26 fucking initiative, Jesus.
Oh my god, how?
I have a +9.
God, okay.
My dex save is a non-natural 20.
I'm getting mine.
So, upon the dex save, you are able to somewhat dodge, but half the bugs still make it onto you, and they start latching into your skin, feeding on you.
My save was 14.
I despise insects.
They're crawling on me!
Just to confirm, wait, Corona, was that, that was a dex.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, my initiative.
Can someone make a list for initiative?
Yeah, I've got it already. I put Corona with 20, because I thought that was his initiative.
This guy is going last, by the way. He has a shit initiative.
Wait, hold on. I have to redo this.
Because my initiative was 6.
Yeah. And then what's his name? Ishmai?
You don't know the name of this guy.
There you go.
Creepy boy. So... What will you do, slut?
He's clearly started a fight.
You're still close to him, yes, and you're still in his grasp.
Great. And he does magic, it seems, right?
It looks like it, but you're not quite sure.
Okay. Hmm. I think it's time for me to cast my Investiture of Ice.
What will that do?
Hello, everyone. Be prepared to see something fun. I'm going to use my Investiture of Ice. It is an action. It is a concentration spell, and it is fucking amazing. Right? So immediately, I am now immune to cold damage and have resistance to fire. Every area around me is now extra terrain due to ice. So the 10 feet around me, no matter what. And
so it's so you created ice around you in a 10-foot circle?
Yes, and I have become a man of ice. And for the rest of the next 10 minutes, I can use my action to create a 15-foot cone of freezing wind extending from my hand in any direction I choose, and they must make a con save or take damage. In the meantime, I will use my bonus action to summon a tentacle behind him and attack him with the tentacle. That's a 27.
You hit.
That's 15 damage.
One moment. I want to see if he can make his reaction real quick.
Yep. And yes, now the 10 feet around me are difficult terrain. Also, I have immunity to this difficulty because snow.
Wait, what did you say? Difficult terrain, something?
Oh, yeah. The 10 feet around me, period, are going to be difficult terrain as ice creeps away from my body.
Okay. Okay, so how much damage are you going to do?
15. Not a lot. It's just a tentacle attack. I just slapped him with a tentacle. It'll do more than that.
You whack against it, and you hear a loud crunch and crackling as almost you hit like some kind of bug carapace.
Ew.
Oh no, it's so gross.
You see some green liquid spurt from the bottom of his cloak, dripping down. This green liquid hits the ground and eats away at it like acid.
Disgusting.
Question that I don't know if you can answer, but does this person count as a beast? Are they like a beast or are they just...
They count as a beast.
Ooh, okay, good to know.
They technically count as a half-beast, but they're a beast nonetheless. So, next turn, Ava. Unless you had something else you wanted to do, slut.
No, I can't do much else right now.
Ava,
I only have a reaction left. I'm just gonna stick to this guy, like ice.
Okay. I want to... Wait, is she also covered in bugs?
No. You two are at the door, so you'd be entering through the doorway.
Okay.
I'll assume the doorway is open now, but you're still in the doorframe.
Yeah. Okay. So, how far away is it from me?
Well, Karada is about 10 feet away from this thing. You're about 15 feet away from it.
15? Okay. I want to use...
How big is that spear again?
No, sir. It's just 10-foot range around me.
Okay, so basically...
Ice on the floor.
The whole room is difficult terrain.
Oh, that's a tiny room.
The room's only 20 feet large. You'd be on the outskirts.
Makes sense.
So, like, okay.
There is a 5-foot range between you and the ice where it isn't difficult terrain.
Okay. I'm going to step forward and I'm going to use Arcane Hand and I'm going to slap it.
Okay.
I'm going to use a level 7 Arcane Hand.
Let's see if you hit it. Or is it an instant spell?
It's an instant spell.
Okay, so how much damage you roll?
33.
Oof. So you smash this thing as you whack your hand across it and you hear a loud crackle and crack, is now the cloak is tore off and you see a humanoid figure. I'm going to show you what it looks like. Posting it in D&D Adventure. You see that wrapped around someone, wrapped around a human or a humanoid, with the wings coming out and its arms wrapped around it as this large bug, and there's bugs crawling all over the humanoid. Some of the acidic blood is then splashed over. Krona, what are you going to do with this acid blood coming towards you? Are you going to attempt to dodge, or...?
Yeah, I'll make a... acrobatics, I guess?
It'd be acrobatics check, if you want to. You could be acid blood on you.
I'd rather not. I hate this thing enough as is. 18? Yeah.
You got 18?
Mm-hmm.
You dodge, stepping on some of the ice, but as you dodge, it just throws onto the wall, slinking and melting the wall, corroding it down and eating away at it.
You get more and more disgusting per second. You realize that, right?
So true.
Then, it is... the bugs start to swarm across the wound. And you can see as the wound gets filled in by the bugs, and some red aura comes from it as the flesh slowly starts to meld together.
In my wounds?
No. Its wounds.
Oh. Oh. Ooh. Hmm.
What will you do now, Ava? So that was ending your turn. Oberon, it's your turn.
Did you say this creature was wearing armor before?
It looks almost kind of like plate armor, but it made out of bug shells.
Gotcha. So it's not metal?
No.
Okay. There goes that idea. That's okay, though. Doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doo. Music while I look. Which, oh my god, guys, I don't think I told you all. I think I only told Les, but I realized last week, right after our session, that I never finished Oberon's character sheet, and I literally hadn't picked out any of his spells. And I had been sitting here looking at my sheet like, why don't I have any good spells? I'm a druid. And I realized I just never picked my spells. So now I have spells, nice. And I promise I can be useful, but I'm also an idiot.
Wow.
Yep.
I'm so proud of you.
Dude, I'm so dumb. Because I had the default spells that come with my proficiency. And I was like, oh, I guess these are just the spells I get. And that's it. No.
I just want you to know, druids know every spell in the druid casting spell.
Yeah, I realized that.
They just have to pick which ones they want to prepare at any point in time. Which is to say, like, you can pick whatever spells you want every morning.
It's true. It's true. And I did not know that until
it's very powerful
again. Because I'm silly. I've never played a druid before, obviously. Okay.
What will you do?
I promise I'm thinking about it. I'm just trying to find my...
Take your time. No need to rush.
Who of my party members... besides Slut, are closest to this thing?
Krona.
Krona?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, instead of attacking, I will give you a buff. Krona, I'm going to give you freedom of movement. That way you can travel on the icy terrain.
Oh, easily. I have resistance to this. I it doesn't matter.
Slut does, but the Krona doesn't.
Off of me.
Yes. Yeah, but the rest of us don't.
I don't have to worry about the icy terrain. It's part.
But what about the rest of us?
Everyone else does.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it to Corona.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So, yep, you are safe. And you also have, you can spend 5 feet of movement to automatically escape from non-magical restraints, if so need.
Ooh, much appreciated.
I got you.
What else will you do?
And I will also, I think that might be the end of my... Yeah. That's the end of my turn. That's all.
Okay, Corona, it's your turn. I want you to make a dex save.
Ah, lovely, lovely. More of these little bastards to deal with. Mm, 17? Yeah.
Okay. So. I think Ava will be back. There we go. Welcome back, Ava. Okay, so you got a 17, eh?
Yep.
So you managed to dodge the other bugs that got off you trying to crawl back onto you, but the ones that are currently on you have eaten away past the skin on your arm. From your shoulder to your elbow is now exposed as raw flesh.
Ah.
Ooh.
How much damage am I taking?
8 damage.
Okay.
Piercing.
Yeesh. But, question. Yes. These are not causing the same metal issues.
No.
Okay. At least these are normal bugs. Fucking hate them. Okay. You know what? If I get to burn with your bugs, you get to burn with my spells. I'm gonna cast Immolation on him.
What does that do?
Flames wreath one creature. The target must make a dex save, or it takes 8d6 fire damage on a failed, and half as much on a successful, plus every...
He got a 9 on his dex save.
Hmm?
9.
Oh.
Oh, he's taking damage.
He's taking a lot of damage. Plus, he's on fire.
Yep.
So, every turn, he will be taking 4d6. So, 8d6 to start, though. Boop, 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 boop. Where are you at? Ah, here we go. Okay, so this shot is doing 29 damage.
Okay. The shot of the fire hits his body, scattering a multitude of bugs across the whole field. Everyone make a dex save.
I'm not sure.
It's bugs, specifically?
Bugs.
Dex
like
save.
Like he summoned bugs?
Huh?
Like he summoned bugs?
No, like they were already on the body.
Okay, so it's not magic.
No.
I was trying to find a way to get my magical advantage, you know? 13.
Nat 20 plus 1.
19 here.
Okay, Ava, what about you?
Hold on. I got a 6.
Okay. Oh boy. First off, Oberon, you managed to dodge out of the way, stepping on the bugs as they land to squash them. Corona, you do the same, so you don't get any more bugs on you. However, Ava, a bunch, like a large clump of bugs now burning, slaps onto your hand as they then mold around your hand, biting into and feasting on your skin. I want you... You are going to take 8 damage, and I want you to make a dex save.
God damn it. Okay. I'm pretty much screaming at this point.
Do I also have to do that thing at 13? Was it 13?
I'm gonna get to you specifically in a bit.
Okay.
As they land somewhere.
And a dex save?
I said a dex save.
I got a 22.
Okay, you managed to smack the bugs against the wall and shake them off you, but your skin now has parts of it which have been eaten off, so there's like little holes exposing raw flesh.
Oh no! My hand! Can I heal myself? Wait, it's not my turn.
When it is your turn. And then, Slut, as the bugs land on you, they freeze, but then as they start to freeze, you can see little spikes of ice forming on them as they continue to crawl towards you. Make a dex save on your leg.
Okay, cool. Ah, fuck. Well, that was a 2 plus 4. Fuck me.
They completely eat all of the skin off your thigh.
Oh, shit.
You, and you deal, and you take 8 damage.
8?
8 piercing damage.
I suppose it makes sense.
That seems like
a bunch of bugs. Because you're made of ice, would the ice hurt you if they were to bite into you?
I'm immune to ice.
Okay.
Part of the spell is that I gain immunity to cold damage, which is ice.
So
I can send you to...
No, I'm fine. So...
Yeah, because it's going to be hard for people to...
No. It is his turn. He is going to cast a spell with his main action. He is going to use a 9th level spell slot to summon Wall of Thorns in between you all.
Counter spell.
You can try.
You can see
that on his whole body, all the bugs are glittering with mana as they absorb the, as they start to bloom out this arcana, shooting out the arcana to then form this wall of thorns, almost like.
Projecting. I also want to do counter spell.
One counter spell at a time, because if it fails, I'm not going to be able to say that you get to counter it.
Okay,
so I'm using counter spell at the highest level I've got. It's a 17 DC.
17 DC?
Mm-hmm.
You don't make it.
Okay.
You need... Because you said you wanted to... You gotta surpass the check, right?
Oh, no. You have to surpass the check.
I have to surpass the check?
Yeah, the DC of my counter spell is 17.
Okay, so I would then have to roll DC.
Mm-hmm.
No, wait, isn't it the other way around?
Mm-mm. You attempt
to... Don't you have to roll to see if you can beat the level of the counter spell?
I mean, if it is a casting a spell of 4th level or higher, make an ability check using your spell casting ability... The DC equals 10 plus the spell's level.
Yes, you make that.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay. Never mind. Let me do that really quick.
Yeah, so what level spell was it?
9.
9? So that's a 19 DC.
So what was the point of me casting at a higher level? Wait a minute.
At a higher level... it has no. You don't have. It doesn't have a benefit at a higher level unless the spell is at the same level. So 4th level.
You fail. I'm gonna say Ava, since he did fail, that you wouldn't be able to. Unless you really want to contest that.
Okay.
Could I have an 8th level counter spell? So that would be 18, but it wouldn't be enough, would it?
Corona. Use your spellcasting modifier. It still would only be a 16, but still.
So, essentially, the Wall of Thorns is then cast. Each of you in this radius, since you are all within reach of this wall, each of you take 48 damage.
Okay. Ow.
Oh, fuck.
So I'm at 1 HP.
Okay.
He's now going to use his bonus action. So, his bonus action, he's going to... He looks over at you, Slut, as he absorbs the cold onto his body, chuckling. You think colds can affect me?
Oh, yes!
You notice his face changes, and his eyes look at you fully, without the humanoid in front of it. If any of you want, you can attempt to ID what kind of bug he is.
I would like to.
Yeah.
Is that insight or investigation?
Nature?
Nature.
Nature, okay.
Nah, I'm good. I have a plus one to nature. I'm not going to waste my high roll.
You could at least try.
I'm not going to waste my high roll on that shit.
17.
You notice that this is a particular bug known as a cold devil.
Oh.
Or a frost devil.
Back.
And they are living back. Their main environment is the Arctic, where they live in guard up on top of the coldest mountains.
Oof.
He's looking at you as this ice spreads upon him as he sucks it across his whole body. Out from his body protrude spikes of ice covering the whole plated armor, snuffing out whatever flames that were there. He then looks over at you, Oberon, as he's going to reach out a hand and extend it, firing off a barrage or a swarm of bugs at you.
Dex save?
He's going to make a DC to hit. Does an 18 hit?
Yep.
The bugs swarm over you. Make a strength save.
21.
Okay, so you manage to hold back your strength onto them, but they are covering your fur, and slowly, they're made up of spiders, and they're slowly ebbing you, reducing your speed by half. If you do not succeed another strength save, you'll be cocooned.
Oh no. Do I roll again now?
Oof. No, on your turn.
Copy.
He is going to now move. He is going to break away from your hand and turn into his swarm form. So, one moment. So, in his swarm form, he cannot get dealt a reactionary attack when he goes into his swarm form, and he cannot receive damage from physical blows.
Okay. Did he take 4d6 from being on fire?
No, he snuffed out the flame.
Oof.
Upon doing so, he turns into a giant swarm of bees, wasps, and locusts. You see this sort of monster dissipate into multiple kinds of bees and locusts, with a humanoid body wrapped up in the middle, covered in large carapaces of all kinds of bugs. And this massive swarm extends, floating in the air as it moves, rushing down the hall to the left, buzzing down it at alarming speed. It moves approximately 30 feet.
That's beautiful. Hold on, I have a question. Would all of these creatures perchance be considered individual creatures?
Technically speaking, yes.
Oh, yeah. Hello. Hi, beautiful. Okay. This will be I don't even have to cast this spell. Oh wait, I didn't do my concept. in my
I'm scared.
If you're gonna try to persuade it, don't. It's a hive mind.
Oh, I made a 10. Never mind. Alright, I wasn't gonna try to persuade it. I just... Hold on. Okay. I have a spell that would be quite useful.
What are you gonna do?
So, you said they all just start spreading and they go up to 50 feet down the corridor, right?
I said they spread into a ball and they go 30 feet down into the corridor.
Great. And that's all within... So I have a total within, like... Every one of them is within 60 feet, right?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh, they're considered an individual, but they are under a hive mind.
But do they technically count as one creature or a different creature?
They count as a group.
Great. How does a cone of cold sound?
It doesn't do anything.
What do you mean? Why didn't it do? Like, if I cast a cold, giant thing of cold magic damage.
He's immune to cold damage.
What yeah, the cold are?
It's a cold devil.
It's a cold
yeah,
devil.
It's resistant to cold.
Bug that is immune to cold damage. It is the only other devil.
Fuck. Well, I guess I wasted my investiture advice.
It's a bug that is completely immune to cold damage.
Hold on. It's going down the hallway right now, right? Yes. Is it trying to retreat?
It's a bug.
You can see that it is fleeing from the battle, so...
Okay.
Right now, it's in its swarm form, though.
Okay.
All right, I'm just going to make... I'll just blast it.
You would need to direct the Eldritch Blast as a winding hallway.
Suggestion. Block it off from leaving. Do not let it leave.
Are we sure we don't want it to leave?
Yes.
I kind of want it to leave.
I have an idea.
Okay. If you get us killed, my ghost is going to haunt you.
Please do. I like spoopy company.
Oh, Lord.
I have to find a spell that's not cold. Hold on. Ah, fuck.
Yeah, so I'm going to post this creature.
Alright.
Right here.
How about this? Can I make a con save for...
Ooh. How cute.
Cute, my ass.
Why are you making a con save?
I'm gonna cast...
No, I don't
know. I'm casting a spell called Blight. I'm moving forward to get closer to it so that it's all ahead of the 30-foot range. As long as I can see it, should be fine. Let me know if it can make a con save for me.
Wait, tell me again why you want to make a con save?
I'm casting Blight on it.
Oh, okay. Go ahead. It'll make con saves. So
yes.
How does a 21 sound?
21 sounds great. Let me give you the half damage. That's 21 damage. Necrotic.
Okay.
21 necrotic damage. As I run forward. And then I guess I don't do anything with my fucking tentacle because it didn't take damage from it. Fuck. Is it? Wait, is it cold? It is cold. Fuck.
It's a cold devil.
I know, but the problem is I'm a cold man.
Next person.
Yep, I just run forward.
Once I heal myself, I'll be able to... I have a few flame and fire spells I can use, so that could be helpful.
I'll heal. I'm gonna heal you.
Okay, so first off, Slut, now it's no longer your turn. Ava, it's your turn.
Okay. I'm going to heal Oberon so he doesn't die. So I'm going to use,
I love that you named him Creaky B-Boy.
A 6th level clear, cure wound.
Okay. How much are you
going to heal? So give me a second. 28.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oberon, it's your turn. Make that strength save.
Oh, yeah. Oops. Yeah. Ooh. I got a 4.
You are fully cocooned now. Upon cocooning, you see that now the spiders have begun feasting upon your body inside, stabbing their little fangs into you, slowly eating from your legs up to you. You are immobilized inside the cocoon, and you cannot move. The cocoon can be pierced. You can still cast magic, but you're restricted to cantrips.
If I were to change my form, if I was to use like my druid form, would that get me out of my cocoon or do anything?
You would need to make a strength save to make sure that you couldn't transform safely without hurting yourself.
Gotcha. Okay.
You can transform most definitely, but if you fail the save, you're gonna break some bones.
Yeah.
Crunchy.
Can I see through my wraps?
No.
Damn. Okay, that's important.
But you can see inside it, and you can see a multitude of spiders covering your feet, gnawing,
epic,
going into your armor, just like digging into your skin, and your fur, tearing it out.
Gee.
No, I tried.
That's okay. I'll just cast a healing spell on. Oh, I can do it. I have to go cantrip. Fuck. Okay. Then I'll try to use my dagger to cut out of it, I guess.
Okay. Roll DC for me.
Oh, is it an 11?
You do not hit.
Fuck.
You can manage to grab your dagger. Upon trying to hit it and strike it, you kind of just like it falls onto your tummy as you attempt to like do something, but you can't really move. Can't get any force to like jab it out.
God damn it.
Fuck. God damn.
Rona, it looks like I'm going to have a rescue over on.
Okay. I want a drink.
Wait, what?
I said I want to drink.
Drink what?
I'm taking
magic vase?
Yes, magic vase.
You're going to drink from the magic vase?
I'm going to drink from the magic vase and summon the cathedral of command.
You're going, okay. You're going to summon underground in this. You're going to summon it right here, right?
Yep.
Okay. So, upon drinking from this vase, the vase echoes with its tubes, outputting steam and smoke. As it whirls, upon doing so, the piano keys turn, extending outwards in terms of tubes. And then pulses as a little vortex of water swirls out from the vase, and you see a massive cathedral spewing up as if from near existence, as it crumbles, crushing above you the ceiling and floors and walls, expanding out in all directions on 120 feet. I want you to make a constitution save, Corona.
Okie dokie.
Everyone needs to make a constitution save.
Is it technically magical?
Yes.
Yes, great.
Oh. No.
Oh.
That's 22.
So what did you get?
7.
I got a 12.
Why am I the only one that got above a 12, guys? What the fuck?
Sorry!
So, you all are put... Oh, God. So, at 120 feet, you all see this thing spreading outwards as upon doing so, white walls push all of you through rooms and rooms and rooms of sedimentary wall. Boom, 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 boom. Oberon, you don't take any damage due to the cocoon.
Pog!
However, Ava, you are smashed back into a wall and being crushed up against a wall in this cathedral wall of wood. You take 18 damage.
Oh, help! Help!
You, Corona, you are smashed all the way back into the original main room where you started. Upon doing so, you are on the ground. You take 18 damage.
Okay.
And, Slut, you are forced and pushed, crushing through each wall, back into the waterway room.
Wait, I got a 22.
Oh, wait, no, you're fine. You managed to hold your ground.
I was about to say.
You hold your ground. You're fine.
Okay.
I'm crying in a wall.
This bug escapes and holds its ground as well, going around the, going around it. It holds its ground. It doesn't take any damage, but it is flung through walls, and it is currently in the waterway room.
Okay, so it's still here. Now that I summon this thing.
You are very far away from it. You have summoned this cathedral. On the outside of the catacombs, the backside of the school has erupted into a mound of this giant cathedral coming out of it, with earth splitting over as part of it falls onto the docks, crushing it and sinking below. The other half falls onto the back part of the, academy, crushing it. As it crumbles down, you can hear loud booming and thundering from above. Krona, I want you to make a dex save.
Okay. Okie dokie.
No! My God. I hurt!
18.
Okay, then. You managed to dodge out of the way of the first boulder. Make another dex save.
God.
Fuck! We're gonna die.
I've got this.
8.
Another boulder fall. A boulder crumbling down from the stairs rolls over your leg. You take 8 damage, and it breaks your leg.
Ah, fuck.
And I'm down.
I hope we have healing.
Yeah, I can heal if I get out of my stupid fucking cocoon.
Are you down? Because there's another boulder that's going to hit you.
Definitely down.
Another boulder comes crashing down, landing on the same leg, dealing 11 damage.
Okay, I'm hurting now.
The way that you have come up originally down those steps has been blocked off completely by a rubble and rock.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Oberon, you are currently smashed up between a rock wall and a wooden wall.
Between a rock and a hard place?
Literally.
Yeah.
I was hoping for a hard place this whole time.
It is now the creepy boy's turn. He is going to exit out of the water gate in the waterway, and he is going to escape to the surface. He is out of sight for all of you and out of most of your guys' range.
Is the battle over?
Yes.
Am I dead?
No, you're not dead. You're unconscious and bleeding.
Hold on. He was 30 feet away from me. How can he disappear, like, out of range?
The cathedral grew.
It shoved
everyone.
I guess, but I...
This cathedral, my dude.
I forgot how big it was.
It takes up 120 feet of space.
God damn it, Corona.
Comparable.
Corona.
Why do you do this?
So...
Excuse me. How many nonsense did you get us into?
So, Slut, you're currently... You're at the door. Somewhere in the tunnels. You don't really know where you are.
Right.
No.
And Oberon, you are next to Ava. You two were smashed back into the ruin, which teleported you back to the rust area where the rust bug once was.
No.
No.
So, what will you all do?
Am I on the surface?
Where the fuck are you, Karina?
Yeah, am I in the spool or
am I
on the surface?
Can I try to get out?
Let me actually see what the fuck my goddamn thing will do for you. Because,
So first off, Ava, what will you do?
Can I heal?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to do a...
Okay, great news. Great news, Corona. You don't drop to 0 hit points.
Okay.
You drop to 1.
Since the battle's over?
Well, no, because when you drop to 0 hit points, my spell book activated, and you drop to 1 instead.
Oh.
It's very cool.
So, Corona, you are alive, but you have a broken leg.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Which is not great.
Okay.
So, Ava, what are you going to do?
Okay.
You're going to heal yourself?
I'm going to do a cure wound on myself, 5th level.
Okay. How much are you going to heal yourself for?
27.
Okay. Oberon, are you going to attempt to get out of your cocoon here?
Yes, please.
What are you going to do?
I'll just try using my dagger again, I guess.
Okay.
Why? It's an 11.
You could create a bonfire.
But I don't want to set myself on fire.
I don't know what you're trying to stat.
Trying to get out of my cocoon.
So, what did you hit with?
Am I near Corona?
No. You're near no one.
Great.
11.
You got an 11?
Yeah.
You don't manage to do it. You just kind of... It tinks and goes onto your belly again. The spiders have made their way from your feet all the way up to your knees. You can feel that your feet are now kind of oozing with a bit of blood from the flesh that has been exposed now.
I'm sorry, I couldn't heal you. I'll try to heal you.
Bleeding. Take 1d4. You take 2 damage, Oberon.
I can handle it. I can handle it. We're fine.
I'll try to heal you next turn, I promise.
No, you're outside
Don't
of battle,
worry about it.
So...
We're good. We'll be fine.
I'm just you can cycling heal between everyone. Corona, what are you going to do?
Okay. I know he just left. How far am I from the actual organ?
Well, you're at the cathedral door, so you would have to make it through the doorway and then make it down the hall about 100 feet crawling to the organ.
There is one benefit that I have, and it's the fact that Oberon gave me freedom of movement.
I got you.
I'm gonna take my ass and crawl to the damn organ.
How much do you... So, make a strength check to open up the door first.
Shit.
What'd you get?
Ooh. Yes! Yes! 19!
You push the door open fully. How far do you crawl?
I'm gonna try and go all the way to the organ.
So, you're crawling, you're You're getting there very, very slowly.
Can I cast haste on myself?
I guess you could.
I need to get to this stupid organ.
Are you going to cast haste on yourself?
Yes, I casted haste on myself.
Okay, you're going to crawl twice as fast as you're almost at walking speed now. As you're walking down, getting faster and faster, you manage to get to the organ seat. Are you going to try to climb up?
Yep.
Okay, you climb up. Now you're at the organ.
And now, in my endearing level of pain, I'm going to try and play so I can finally control the swarm form.
Okay.
You know, be very... I wish we could get inside.
Make a performance with disadvantage because you don't have a leg to play with.
Okay. There's one. And here's the other one.
It's only one performance right now.
Right. That was with disadvantage, right? Mm-hmm. Nine.
Okay, you managed to play this organ, but it's very bad. It's very terrible, as it's just... You're kind of like mashing on the keys. It doesn't sound good at all. You all hear this kind of like loud organ playing, like there's like just someone mashing on some organ keys somewhere, and everyone in the town is confused at what the fuck is there. Why is there a cathedral out of the ground? The fuck? And then they're like, ah, god, it's fucking awful from the noise. So you do not succeed upon controlling it.
Oh. How far has it moved now? Do I get another shot or no?
You get another shot at it.
Okay.
Remember, still with disadvantage.
Right. There's one.
You do know you can just right-click.
Oh, really? Oh, shit.
Right-click on your performance.
Uh-huh. And roll... Oh, roll disadvantage. Okay. Sick. Either way, it was roughly the same.
You play it so badly still that it's you're starting to get your bearing in terms of rhythm, but it still sounds like mashing keyboards. Like dun 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 dun.
I'm gonna take this opportunity to apologize to my organ.
It can't talk to you right now because you haven't imbued it with Arcana.
Oh, right.
It can talk to you in its vase form, but not in its like organ form. Because you haven't been with Arcana yet. So, upon doing so, it doesn't really say anything. Now cycling back, Slut, you're currently at an unknown part of the catacombs. What will you do?
Well, I'm gonna try to first, I know this wall was behind me. Was there a cave-in? Can I see the wall of the cathedral?
From where you got put, from where there is a hole, you can see the cathedral's white walls. About a hundred, not a hundred, about 50 feet away from you.
Mm-hmm. Well, shit, and I can't, can I get next closer to it?
Yeah, you can crawl there, or walk there.
Okay, because I would love to use a Misty Step to get inside, but that's 30 feet. So, let me just actually check Misty Step, see if I see where the fuck I'm going. Oh, no, I can't even do it because I have to see where the fuck I'm going. Okay, I guess I'm going to explore the cavern on the other side.
You're not going to go towards the cathedral?
I've... Is there, I guess I'll go to the cathedral. Is there like any entrance to it that I can see?
No, it's just a white wall there that stuck out from one of the holes of the crumbling catacombs. You could try to break the wall down.
I doubt that'll work.
You could attempt.
I feel like it would be a very funny thing to just break your fucking castle we just got last session, but I don't feel like a dick. So let's go down the other side of the catacombs.
Okay. So you walk through the catacombs, and as you continue to walk through, you notice some very familiar tiling, and you reside back to where you once were before.
Oh, that's cool. Is there a way to, like, explore my way back to where I would understand the cathedral would be?
You know what I'm saying? Like, you went the other direction, but you're back where you originally were standing, 50 feet away from the cathedral.
Oh.
What I'm saying is you went in a circle.
Well, that's fucky. Well, shit. I guess I'm going to crawl towards the cathedral.
Okay, you walk over towards the cathedral. How you just walk up to its walls. What will you do?
I'm gonna try and like see if I can move down the sides of it. Like, is my the wall I'm at just completely caved in? Like, it can
so
can
where
I
the
shift
cathedral
my way
is
to
the in the
rest side?
Of the catacombs? You can see, but what I'm saying is, when it pushed out, it's pushed all the rubble with it. So like, there is just only that way to go. It's just a bunch of holes through the wall where you got pushed to. You got bashed through multiple walls. So it's just kind of like a cylindrical tube moving forward.
Well, I'm going to knock on the wall. Hope that Corona can hear me.
Corona, you can hear from about 50 feet away to like the left wall. There's a knocking sound.
What do you want, you stupid kids?
Why, I want you, my dear. I thought this was quite understood.
Hello, dumb slut. Get in here.
I can't. There doesn't seem to be a door.
Make one.
You want me to destroy your cathedral?
I don't care about the cathedral. I care about the organ.
Alrighty, then. And I'm just gonna cast Eldritch Blast into the wall. Burst down.
Okay, roll DC.
It's 28.
Would Eldritch Blast is necrotic, right?
No, it's force. It's just pure force.
Pure force, okay. So it's not necrotic damage.
Nope.
Good.
It's one of the few force spells.
So it busts open a wall, just a large like hole.
Yeah.
That can be seen. Into this nice looking cathedral.
Why, hello there.
Why, hello, Corona. Question. I slowly start to walk closer.
Yes.
Are you missing a leg?
No, it's attached. It's just useless.
Well, you seem to be wobbly. That's why I'm asking.
Three limbs tends to do that to people.
Well, I may not be able to fix it, but I might have an idea if we get everyone else. Do you have an idea where they went?
Everyone got pushed in different directions.
So, somewhere. That's very helpful. If you would like, if we could close this cathedral, I have a much smaller palace that we could get into. That way, when they come towards the hole, there is a passageway to the entry.
As much as I would appreciate that, I'm still trying to play this stupid organ.
Would you like some assistance?
I mean, I'm not sure what happens if you try to play it.
I have 10 points.
I'll move over and let him try to play.
Ray, I'm going to go try to play the organ. Can I touch the organ?
You can attempt to touch the organ.
I'm attempting to touch the organ in a performative manner.
You touch the organ, and then you hear it speak to you.
Oh, great.
For who touches my handles, and for why are you touching me?
Oh, well, that's quite interesting. I was informed that you needed someone to play a song, so I was here to play music for you.
Does thou, master, give you permission?
I was given permission by the man whose leg is broken sitting next to me, yes.
I want to say...
Oh, shit. Corona, please speak.
Corona,
speak to this organ.
I'm going to gently pet the organ.
You pet the organ as it then speaks to you. For who is this cynical man touching my handle?
An imbecile with functioning limbs.
Hey.
I see.
I didn't hear that. Hey.
Have you given However, him permission, master, to play me?
I have indeed given him permission for the moment, just this once.
Huh?
He then speaks to you, slut, for you have been given permission to play me, for my jux power is upon you.
Mm. Why, thank you.
Play with and I'm disadvantage gonna... because it makes, make a performance check with disadvantage because he's almost out of range.
No. Reaction command. Perfect.
Well, great news. With disadvantage, either way, I had an 11 plus 10.
Okay, you managed to play this tune, and upon playing it, everyone in the surrounding area can hear this tune. The bug swarm that is also can hear this, he needs to make a wisdom save.
I do?
No, he does.
Oh.
Yes.
He succeeds.
Darn it.
He resists it. It's just slowing him down. It's slowing him down. You don't know where he's going because you can't see him. However, you do have control over all the people in the town.
Hmm. You know what could be useful with this? It could be useful to bring Ava and Oberon. Well, you know what? Let me do it in my character's. It would be quite useful if you can bring everyone back to the cathedral.
That would be extremely useful. What a wonderful idea. Why don't you do that?
That's a good point! How do I do that?
You would have to think with that intention and make another performance check.
Glad. I will want the party to come back to the
cathedral. This time it's a normal performance.
Great.
You know what? Actually, here's a good question. It's an organ, right? So it's rather large. Funny. What happens if we tried to duo play the organ?
Only one person can play at a time.
Gotcha. Okay.
So, upon playing it with your natural 20, what happens is everyone in the surrounding area gets this message and compelling message to find your party. They don't know who the party is, so they make a party themselves, and they start having a party in the town.
That's fine.
Love it.
That's perfectly fine. Everyone's returning to their parties.
What about the party that actually knows that we're a party?
Yeah.
You can still play it if you want to make another request, but be specific.
I mean, I was
directly to Oberon and Ava and tell them to come to the cathedral.
I want to play specifically for these two people. One of them is a cat. What race is Ava? She was a tiefling?
I'm not a fucking cat.
And you're a kind of cat. Are you asking the people to find... Are you wanting the people to find them? Or are you wanting them to...
No, I want them. I want to identify them in my mind. I want to play solely for them to come to the cathedral.
I want each of you, Oberon and Ava, to make a wisdom save.
Let me do another performance. That's a 17.
I got a 5.
22.
Okay, so Oberon, you managed to resist this organ music. It just sounds like really good organ music. Ava, you hear this, and you start clawing and banging on the wall. 50 feet away from you, you hear clawing and banging.
Found them.
Help! Get me out! I'm hurt!
I'm done. Great!
Over the bottom.
I can't use Eldritch Blast to break this wall, because otherwise it'll blast outward.
Alright. I'll take care of this one.
So you're gonna crawl over them, Corona?
I'm gonna crawl over, and...
You have 1 point of exhaustion.
Yeah. what to use? Fuck it. I'll toss a firebolt at the wall.
Okay. Roll for DC.
What?
Mmm, 26.
You hit the wall. What do you do for damage?
Doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-dee-doo-doo. Even crippled, I do damage.
How much damage?
16.
Oberon and Ava, you take half that damage. 8. The wall breaks open as they both fall to the ground, taking 8 damage.
Does my cocoon protect me at all?
It protects you from the fall, but not from the fire.
Oh.
The firebolt does fire, right?
Yes, it does.
It is now... It burned the wall, but it didn't burn through to you. But you do still get the force of it. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
So you fall to the ground. Oberon, you can try to break out again if you want.
Yeah, I want to get out of this fucking thing.
Would Wolverine not have this advantage on that whiz save based on the fact that they're almost dying?
Wolverine, you manage to break through the carapace with your dagger. Upon doing so, you break through it, stabbing. You cut a little sliver away until you can get your hand out, and you can now take the dagger out with your hand. What are you going to do with it?
Cut myself out of the cocoon.
You slowly cut yourself out. I want you to make a dex save for the spider.
Well, oh, 10.
Okay, they've eaten their way up to your middle thigh as they've eaten around it, and a few of them have crawled onto your lion cock.
Don't eat my lion dick! I knew you were gonna say it! I don't want them on my lion dick!
It's too big for them to ignore, no!
No! No! My fat, juicy lion cock, god damn it!
So,
no!
Your thighs are starting to get ate up, and they're biting on your lion cock now. So, you get out of the carapace, you can try to shake them off you with a dex save.
Question first, how many are there?
Enough to cover your entire shin, kneecap, and half your thigh.
So, like, just like a fuck ton, like more than 10.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I'll do a dex save. God fucking damn it. 7.
You try to shake them off, it kind of looks like a really shitty dance.
Yeah. Sounds
and,
right.
None of them really fall off. They only get angrier and start crawling and biting faster.
Nah.
Can I slap his lion dick?
What?
Well,
no!
It's currently in his armor, so no.
Get the fuck away from
I'm
my
I'm sorry, the dick armor?
You would have
Oberon
to...
is a druid, right?
You would have to reach into his pants.
I'm wearing leather armor, but I'm also actually wearing a chastity belt.
Oh, wait, so it's just a little skirt.
A leather chastity belt. Remember, you can't wear metal.
Oh, I know. It's a medium level leather chastity belt encasing my dick.
What is a chastity belt? It's like just like leather, like, is it like that leather skirt thing?
A chastity belt is to prevent one from having sex.
Or so, touching one's penis.
Exactly. So it's basically a cage for his dick, I guess.
Yeah, it's a dick cage.
Like Red Dawn, except for his dick.
He has. What's very ironic about this is that this is basically the carcass of another animal you're wrapping your dick around your
Absolutely
dick.
Absolutely right.
So, like,
So what, you wearing pants, or are you wearing a little skirt thingy?
I'm wearing pants.
Okay, so the spiders have crawled into your pants.
Spiders.
They are in your pants right now. What are you gonna do?
Fuck me, man.
Take
them. Will it make a fucking difference if I try to, like, change my shape? I don't think that would even do anything.
You could change your shape right now if you wanted.
Well, here's something that's beneficial for you. Mm-hmm. If you do shape wild shape, usually that animal takes the damage and you do not.
That's fair.
Generally how it works.
That's fair.
So maybe your body.
And then you guys can blast me with fire and kill all of them, and then we'll switch back. I'll change into a bear.
Okay, you change into a bear in front of everyone as your mouth and whole body distorts, growing larger, more muscular, and into this bear.
Rawr.
No.
You're no longer cute. Why are you no longer cute?
Are you saying bears are not cute?
Yes.
They're equally cute, if not more cute than lions.
So, what are you gonna do? Anyone? Anything?
Someone help me.
Do you want me to
only
cast
thing
fire?
I can do
I barely have any heal. Damage that could do shit, and most of my damage is single target. I'm sorry. I can't.
Okay.
I really can't.
Just cover my body in fire, man. I'll take it.
I'm going to use, first and foremost, 4 points of 4 sorcery points and give Oberon Bastion of Law, which is a certain number of d8s equal to the sorcery points worth of shielding.
Ooh.
So now that I do that, I'm going to cast Firebolt on him.
Firebolt or Fireball? Fireball would be better.
Fireball would probably be better.
Firebolt is a single target. Fireball is a range. It would kill all the creatures.
I do not have Fireball, sadly.
Aren't you a sorcerer?
Yes. You aim it away.
But if I'm the target and it catches my fur on fire, wouldn't it affect the spiders?
Yes.
Chromatic orb. Much better.
Aren't you a... how do you not have... What?
You get chromatic.
Okay, so what are you gonna do, Corona?
I'm going to toss a chromatic orb at his nuts.
Oh.
It's one of the strongest spells. You should get Fireball.
Okay, so roll for damage.
Okay. And an extra 1d8. And boop, 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 boop. So 18 plus 9. Okay. No, 18. No, 18 plus 6. Okay. 24.
So you deal, this chromatic orb surrounds the dick and ball of this bear as it's slanging from it. And upon doing so, surrounds his lower torso with a raging fire. It burns all of the spiders in fur down to the skin. as it burns them all away. It also seals over your burn. It also seals over your flesh marks.
Yay, cauterization.
No.
It looks all raw and weird.
Oh, goodness. Right.
I'll turn back.
So you turn back, Oberon, and upon turning back, your boots, you know, your clothes are all the same, your boots are all the same, your equipment's not changed, but all of your raw flesh that was there is all seared over with a black heart, with almost like a black scab of like burned flesh.
Ouchy, yeah.
You're currently
we're all together now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who needs healing?
You could take a rest if you want.
Yes, can we rest, please?
You are in a safe place due to the cathedral.
A long rest?
Yeah, you could.
I would imagine we're not really in a safe place due to the fact that we broke the walls.
No, I'm saying the cathedral itself is a safe place.
I would like to summon my impenetrable fortress inside the cathedral.
No. Please don't. No, we're crushing buildings. I don't want to die.
Wait. We can just stand against the wall and I can summon it in the middle of the room. It fits in here just fine.
So we'll be in a fortress inside of a cathedral inside of a sewage area.
Yes, exactly. Thank you for understanding. I toss it in the middle of the room away from everybody.
I want you to roll a d20.
Oh my
god. For fuck's sake, it's not that big.
Compatibility.
Oh.
I just want to...
11.
So as you try to make this fortress appear, what happens is they both the organ, so the cathedral, the organ, and the fortress, what happens is upon you summoning the fortress, it grows and then shrinks back down to size as some invisible force is forcing it to not grow. And what happens is it then ricochets back and hits you in the gut.
Well, that didn't work. I guess we could go upstairs and lock all the doors.
Can I just go to sleep?
So, if you remember the passives again from this weapon, not weapon, this cathedral.
Mm-hmm. Chance is a safe place. 100 feet.
When I say safe place, is that it has a protection of good and evil, so if anything evil tries to enter, it has to bash against the wall, and it gets refracted.
Yes.
When I say safe place, it's about as safe as your impenetrable fortress. With the exception as it can still be burned, it can still be maimed, it can still have damage to it, but physical attacks, I'd say you're pretty much fine.
More lovely.
I'd say for this long rest, you would be okay. If you want to attempt again to summon your fortress, you can try.
No, I think I'm fine.
Can someone carry me to a room? I'm kind of like dead.
When we do long rest, I forget. Does that restore HP?
It does.
It does?
Yes. You just click on
the I couldn't remember.
I'm just
I'll carry you, Corona.
I will limp to a room and just pass out on any bed or piece of furniture.
So, in the top of the cathedral, there are multiple rooms. There are 6 on the left side and 6 on the right side, with the middle leading back behind the organ. Choose from a number of the rooms.
Oh, shit.
Left number 4.
I would love the ones behind the organ.
No, there's one,
where you want to go.
One room behind the organ, which leads to all of its pipes and shit. But you can choose many number of the 6 rooms in any one of the sides.
Oh, okay, 3.
Okay. Upon entering the room of number 3, you see there is just a small bed. In each one of the rooms, there is a king-size bed, one nightstand with a desk and a couple of books in there. They're all blank books, and there is some ink on the desk to write things in.
Ava's just gonna pass out in her room.
Are all the rooms identical?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank goodness. I'm gonna go into room 4.
Oberon,
I'll go into number 5.
Okay.
I'll carry you into room 4. I'll put you in bed, and then I'll go to my next room over.
Okay. So,
is someone gonna heal Corona's leg?
It's a long rest.
That doesn't heal a broken leg.
True.
You don't wake up the next morning with a fixed broken leg. You need greater restoration.
I can heal it, maybe. Do I have greater restoration?
I'll say this. There's a couple ways you could do this. You could use a medicine check to try to set the leg. You could use magic to heal it and set it. Or you could use a physical doctor set, if you had one, to set it.
I have good medicine, actually. I could probably set it.
Okay, make a medicine check for me.
Oh, no. Okay, I got a 16.
Okay.
You manage to set his leg within a cast between two pieces of wood and twine. It is set up to heal so that in the morning his leg will have healed to half capacity. You won't be able to carry anything super heavy. You won't be able to carry anything heavy or with a... large encumbrance, but you will be able to walk.
Oh, actually? Let me see. So, which spells would be able to, which healing spells would have any effect on a broken leg? I'm not sure.
Restoration, usually?
Let me look at your healing spells.
I have Healing Word, Mass Cure Wounds, Heal. I have a handful.
So any of your healing word. Heal Word and Cure Wounds would just heal it?
Yeah.
Instantly, but if you're wanting to set it specifically, greater restoration?
Greater restoration
would set it properly. Your medicine check would be able to set it. With your current medicine check, you can set the leg to be able to heal correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Just, it won't have full capacity when he wakes up. If you use greater restoration, it sets it and on its way for accelerated healing. Meaning when he wakes up, it's fully functional.
I also have greater restoration.
Heal yourself, bitch.
No one asked me.
So, Oberon, you have set it to be half as successful. You leave the room...
What if it's set and then you heal it? Does that help at all?
If you set it and then you heal it, you would be able to... So you've set it at half capacity. Any healing magic from this point onward... We'll make it to a full set and slightly heal him. I'll say it heals him for half of whatever you choose to heal him with, but it will set it.
Okay.
Or, that's any healing magic, or you can use greater restoration to fully set it and accelerated healing, meaning he gains temporary hit points.
I don't have greater restoration.
Are you going to use greater restoration for yourself, Corona?
I'm gonna wait to see if Oberon does anything, just to see if they care enough.
I do. I was trying to buff you so hard. You can't die now, you stupid bitch. You gotta have a good leg. Oberon's like, we can't have a lame leg in our party with us. I have to fix this up. You'll slow us down otherwise.
I forgot, I don't sleep. I'm just gonna be reading my book all night.
Okay, so I'll cast, oh my god, I'm so sorry, I have so many. You said, healing word?
Any healing magic whatsoever. So, okay, your medicine check, half set it, meaning that in the morning, if he was just to sleep on it,
mm-hmm.
it will heal itself. But also, he'll be back up to full HP, but he won't be able to put any heavy weight on his leg, meaning he won't be able to pick up any heavy items.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a sword or something, he won't be able to pick it up without maybe potentially injuring himself again. So it'll be a weaker leg. Or if he gets hit on that leg, it'll probably break again.
Okay. So
but if you use any healing magic, it will repair it to be fully set, meaning it's going to heal up to maximum strength. But you do half the amount of healing you would in the healing.
For the
gotcha. For so health. I'm just going to do my level 8 mass cure wounds just to really make sure that shit sets. Oberon, under the guise that he doesn't want someone weak in his party, he's a little concerned. And so I'll cast that. I'm sleeping, so it doesn't matter. All right, 36.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Okay.
You are healed for 17 HP, and upon it's fully set and strengthened. Now, when you wake up, you will have a fully strengthened leg.
Oh, doctor, thank you.
Get some sleep. I'll see you in the morning.
Now, Oberon,
he fucking just dips out and goes to his room, goes to sleep.
Currently, so Oberon, are you going to do anything about your injuries?
I mean,
you could make a medicine check to assess it.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, what do you get?
Oh, now I get a nice roll. Okay, 25.
Okay, you assess the situation. Upon assessing your situation, your burnt legs from the thigh down, you note that you have stopped all kinds of bleeding and infection from occurring. However, it is still very tender and scabbish, meaning anything light that could prick at it could peel off the scab. Also,
ouch.
It is within healing, so if you were to somehow use any kind of healing magic, you could repair your skin or the scab to strengthen it. So here's what you have left. If you have normal healing magic, so lesser restoration will make it so that your scab doesn't infect. Greater restoration will make it so that your scab turns into skin. And then healing magic will make it so that you have skin growing when you wake up. Like, skin will be growing over it when you wake up. And it'll be a new, fresh layer of skin, meaning you're protected from snags and shit.
Cool. Is anyone else... Because I could do this in a mass... Because I can do mass cure wounds again at level 7. Does anyone else have any wounds that they want healed by morning?
Ava still has her hand.
I need healing. I need a healing.
Okay, and then Slut, are you okay?
Oh, I'm perfectly fine, honey. Focus on focus on Corona.
Your leg has an injury.
Me?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, they
ate my skin. I'm fine.
Okay, so I'm gonna go to Ava's room. I know she just laid down. I'm gonna pick her up, and then I'm gonna go to Slut's room, and I'll cast Mass Cure Wounds at level 7 on all three of us.
Or just give me a burn heal. Jeez.
Okay. You just upon doing so, okay, so first off, Slut, your skin has scabbed over completely and has become a hard scab, meaning skin will heal on the next rest you have.
That's fine.
But it is weakened, so if something does strike you, you can get the scab peeled off fairly easily, and you'll be bleeding. So remember to protect that. Also, you are healed for 10 HP. Ava, same for your hand. There's little tiny holes about the size of an Oreo on the top and bottom of your palm. You've scabbed over. And then, Oberon, your scab has... Your scabbing from your burning has hardened over, and some skin, a new fresh coating of skin, will be healed over you when you wake up.
Question. Would it be metal?
You don't know.
Okay, cool. Just wanted to know. Sweet, sweet. Then, there we go. Everyone's okay. I go sleep.
I have no idea if it'll be metal or not.
Okay. I'll bring Ava back to her room, and then I'll go back to mine. And then I'll finally pass out.
Yeah, okay, Ava's not.
Anyone else want to do anything?
Nope.
Okay, session end.